Okay.
This is Salong Flyttkartong. It first started with me actually just buying a tattoo machine. Do it yourself, like, attitude. But then people start to recognize me and how I tattoo, and people kind of started wanting to have the same, you know. Think it was a style or something.
Linnea as an artist is so for real, it's so hard, it's so right on.
She's doing this project and she's going all in with herself and her body. And
working with my hands is super important. I like to feel the material. And right now it's the skin of other people's and mine.
It's this combination of speed in the decision, speed in or grasping the moment or something like that, and keeping it forever.
Alltså jag måste komma på varför det blir svart där. Thinking. Måste ha krympt. När folk vill ha för snygga tatueringar, då blir man vänsterhänt.
Visually it is ugly and beautiful at the same time.
Det var någon jag glömde här förut. When I was young I didn't think so much about tattoos because I was afraid of needles, but then I came over it. When someone tell me I make ugly tattoos, I don't care. It's a question of aesthetic. When I came up with a name, Salong Flyttkartong, because I didn't have anywhere to stay at the moment, and all of my friends, everybody's like living around in cardboard boxes. A simple name, like Salong Flyttkartong.
The interesting of the project is her way of dealing with it. She has no control of it during the time she's doing it. Kind of, she just lives it. She makes art through her life.
Sometimes when I tattoo people, I spell things wrong. We often laugh about it. They know who they are coming to. I work with my everyday life as a performance, like a performative research. It's like 24/7. Hello?
Hello, how are you doing?
Nice. I'm in my studio. Yeah, you can come by. Of course, everybody's welcome here. Come over at like 7 or something. I hooked up with these guys like for over a year ago, and we have like the similar maybe idea of how I tattoo and how they work with clutter and graffiti. So we kind of just morphed into like Salong Flyttkartong together. To clear my head, I need to get fucked up.
Of course, Salong Flyttkartong is a much bigger art piece than just the crazy energy, the crazy people, the party and all the motion.
The act before thinking, for me it's for myself, it's to push my limits and boundaries. It's about losing control and also just going straight ahead and don't be afraid.
The piece itself has its own life.
I think we all like are really good friends now, and we have the same like energy and restlessness. And
art you can do in many different ways, and this is one of them.
So this is my home. I have my bed here now. I live here. So the cardboard box is the setting for my work.
Her studio is inspiring. Everything becomes art in there. What I think attracts people is that she's not making excuse for herself.
The play with identity is the identity. It's some kind of performative identity, I think.
Hej verkligheten. Fy fan. Straffarbete.
And there is also something interesting because I think her project has been, now it's on a lot of people's bodies with all these tattoos. So there's like her Salong Flyttkartong is walking around the whole city in a way.
The problem with my studio is that nobody cleans it up. The studio is my brain and my thoughts and my thinking materialized.